David Beckham. The Englishman is probably one of the most well-known footballers in the world. He definitely needs no introduction, but over the course of his career, he played for Manchester United, Real Madrid, LA Galaxy, AC Milan, and then finishing off his wonderful footballing career at PSG. And after he retired, he didn't really delve into football management straight away like most retirees do. Beckham launched a few businesses, went into fashion, modeling, even being a spokesperson and being involved in UNICEF. Albeit, he's the current president of Inter Miami CF and the co-owner of recently promoted to the Football League, Salford City. I mean, Beckham, it's all well and good that you got all these different ventures going on in your life. I mean, you're probably a very busy man, but why not try your hand at football management with Tottenham Hotspur, the North London club, and try to be successful in an England rebuild challenge on FIFA 19 career mode. So the goals and objectives for David Beckham are going to be: number one, ensure that the starting 11 and the whole entire club is all English. Number two, sell all non-English players at the club. Number three, at least win a Premier League, a domestic cup competition, and of course the Champions League, which we will go on and play the final. Number four is that Beckham has a 5-season time limit on the challenge. And number five, David Beckham has to be successful in his first stint in football management while signing, developing, and growing the next big talents in English football. And yeah, deliver success in your debut managerial stint. Yeah, I think that's fair enough. Let's get into season number one. Now, I know I feel like I say this every week, but this has been one of the most highly requested rebuild challenges ever. Everyone watching from England have been requesting this one with so many different clubs, with so many different people, but the one I saw the most was a David Beckham challenge. This is the current situation at the club. As you guys know, Spurs already have a lot of English talent in the side, such as Harry Kane, Dele Alli, Harry Winks as well, Kieran Trippier and Danny Rose. So it was fitting to do an English challenge with Tottenham Hotspur. Recently, we were in the Champions League final and just lost out to Liverpool. But in David Beckham's first season in charge, got £127.5 million to spend. I'm sure he'll be very effective and efficient with his finances. I mean, he runs a few businesses. He's pretty much an entrepreneur by now. He should be taking some care and have a lot of control over the club. And yes, like in every rebuild challenge, all the non-English players or all the non-specified players will be on the transfer list, like Vertonghen, Alderweireld, Lucas Moura. As you can see, we've already put them all on the transfer list. So I'm sure there's going to be a lot of player departures as the rebuild continues. And just like last week with the African rebuild challenge, if you haven't seen it, make sure to check it out on the channel. There is an abundance of young English talent in FIFA 19 career mode and has been for so many years. So we'll be showcasing that off today. No need for the youth scouts in this one. So let's see how this squad changes, who David Beckham will sign, who he'll get rid of, and how this squad will take shape under David Beckham's reign. Let's see the English revolution in full effect in season number one. This summer transfer window is going to be crazy. So Beckham has found Harry Kane's strike partnership for this side. We have brought in Marcus Rashford, one of the best young English talents to come on the scene in the past few years. The 20-year-old we picked up from Manchester United for £37.4 million. Now 83 overall, has an insane potential on career mode and will definitely be growing into this side and form up an amazing partnership with Harry Kane. So it looks like we are set on the goalkeeping position for the rebuild. We have picked up the England international, England's number one, Jordan Pickford. He has joined Beckham's English revolution. The 24-year-old has come from Everton for £30.2 million. Now 83 overall, he'll definitely be starting in between the sticks. And what are the breakout stars? One of the biggest English wonder kids to burst onto the scene this season, it is going to be Chelsea's Callum Hudson-Odoi, who was controversially benched by Sarri throughout the season. He is going to come and join the English revolution for £5 million. Of course, he's got an absolutely brilliant potential on career mode. The 17-year-old, 71 overall, is the next big thing in English football, and I think he'll really shine and develop under David Beckham's guidance. Callum Hudson-Odoi, welcome to Spurs. And I don't usually show it, but an offer coming in for our player, the man leading the line for this English revolution, the captain of this side, Harry Kane, Spurs' own, got an offer here from Real Madrid. There is obviously no way we are selling Harry Kane, so Real Madrid, say goodbye to that dream. Jan Vertonghen is departing the club, the 31-year-old Belgian centre-back, off to France. He's joining Monaco for £38.3 million. He's been a loyal servant to Spurs over the years. So a major player departure here, one of Spurs' best players this season, one of the most improved since they signed him a few years ago. ago, Heung-min Son, the South Korean, the 26-year-old attacker for Spurs, is off to Barcelona for £75 million. He is joining the Camp Nou, Messi and co, and is off to Spain. The 87-rated Korean is finally departing Tottenham. So the old Spanish striker that fired Spurs into the Champions League semi-finals beating Man City, Fernando Llorente, he's going to be departing the club for £4.25 million. The 33-year-old Spaniard, 76 overall, is off to Lazio in Serie A. So after a few player sales, they were able to beef up the transfer budget in order to pick up Ruben Loftus-Cheek. Chelsea's English midfielder is joining yet another London club here for £15.5 million, and now 22-year-old. Going to be a cheap alternative in midfield. He's a solid central midfielder, and I'm sure will flourish in the English Revolution. So in my eyes, it's the Heung-min Son replacement. As the Korean left for Barcelona, we have been able to pick up Borussia Dortmund's bright young starlet this season, Jadon Sancho. The next big thing, the bright young talent in English football everyone is talking about. He is linked with a lot of top European clubs, especially English clubs this season. Still only 18 years of age. A very youthful replacement for Ronaldo, still only 80 overall, but can grow up to plus 90. So I'm very keen to see how he grows and develops under David Beckham. And I almost forgot, we picked up Mr. Sancho for £15.9 million, plus Eric Lamela, the Argentinian winger, is headed off to Borussia Dortmund. So we've picked up our first centre back for Tottenham Hotspur. It is going to be filling the void of Jan Vertonghen leaving. Harry Slabhead Maguire, the man is coming over from Leicester for £28.4 million. He took over the World Cup, and now he's going to take over the English Revolution under David Beckham. The 25-year-old will fit straight into that starting centre-half role. Now 82 overall, 88 strength on him. Welcome to Tottenham. So the former Irishman in Jack Grealish, the main man behind Aston Villa's promotion to the Premier League this season, has joined us here at Spurs for £10.5 million. The 22-year-old has been linked to Spurs so many times throughout the past two seasons. It has been incredible how he hasn't made the move yet, but I'm sure he will shine in the Premier League next season. 76 overall, he has that something special. Welcome to David Beckham's side. So the mastermind of quick corner taking, Alexander-Arnold Trent, is coming to Tottenham Hotspur. The Liverpool wonder kid, the Liverpool ace, 19 years of age, is signing for Spurs for £26.5 million. A Liverpool fan favourite and probably one of their best players this season. I'm not sure how they're going to feel about that one. So within the first season, Bex has picked up a backup goalkeeper for Jordan Pickford. The man who's in the championship for Stoke City, Jack Butland, finally agrees to terms here at Spurs. And it's a cheeky little swap deal. £14.3 million we had to shell out, plus the Argentinian goalkeeper Paulo Gazzaniga. And now Butland is signing a 5-year deal in North London. So I dare say it again, yet another bright promising prospect in English football at the moment. Man City's own Phil Foden is coming and joining us here for £12.4 million. He's switching over to Spurs for £12.4 million. The 18-year-old, still very, very young, and he is one of those star players that have burst onto the scene in the last couple of years for England. I'm so jealous right now of how good English football is. So I don't know how to really explain this, but somehow, some way, Liverpool have activated Christian Eriksen, the 26-year-old centre attacker midfielder. The Dane is headed off to Anfield for a whopping £117.4 million. That is crazy money. A 9-figure sum there for Christian Eriksen, and is going to allow us to get a few more decent players before the transfer window ends. He is off to Liverpool. Thank you, Jurgen Klopp, for shelling out that amount of money. So right after Liverpool pick up Christian Eriksen, we go and pull out the no you card by signing Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain. The Ox is coming to Spurs. The now 24-year-old centre midfielder, 80 overall, we had to spend $23 million on him in order for him to come to Tottenham. He's expressed his hate ever so publicly for Tottenham throughout the years. Of course, the ex-Gunner, welcome to Spurs, Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain. I know I've ruffled a few Arsenal fans' feathers there. So a few minor player departures going on here. At the moment, we've got Moussa Sissoko, the French midfielder. He's off to Bournemouth. The Cherries pick him up for £17.5 million. I hope they enjoy him giving away handballs in their penalty area. The Kenyan midfielder, Victor Wanyama, now 27 years of age, ex-Southampton man, is going to Leicester City for £13.9 million, as well as one fourth. The 20-year-old Argentinian centre-back is making the switch from the Premier League to the Turkish League for £9.4 million. So we've got a bit more money coming into the transfer budget there. So we are still living off this Christian Eriksen transfer fee. We have been able to pick up one of England's best players at the moment, Raheem Sterling from Manchester City, for £78 million. Our most expensive transfer yet, and it's going to be well worth it because he's still 23 years of age. He's already 87 overall and he can grow to well above that. So Raheem Sterling is going to be a welcomed marquee addition in the side. And I'm sure Manchester City fans won't be too happy about that switch. So it's a Manchester City double swoop here. Pep Guardiola has sold us two of his best players here. John Stones, the English centre-back, is making the move to Spurs. We finally pick up a centre-back partner for Harry Maguire. And to be fair, they are centre-back partners in the English national team. So it was only right for $36.9 million. The 24-year-old's coming to North London. And maybe the Becks can teach John Stones a thing or two about defending. So I didn't mean to do it. We accidentally sold an English player. And that is going to be Kyle Walker-Peters. The 21-year-old right-back I accidentally accepted an offer for from Villarreal in the Spanish league for $4.45 million. It's not like he's one of our main English players. I mean, that's good. But I didn't really want to sell any English players. And then also Michel Vorm, the Dutch goalkeeper, is off to Nottingham Forest for $2.35 million. He's going back down to the Championship. But those two sales, whether they were meant or not, are going to allow us to maybe get one more signing before the window closes. So one more signing it is then. Those two sales were able to let us pick up Declan Rice, the former Irishman, now changing his nationality to English. For a fee of £11.3 million, he makes the switch to the north of London from West Ham. The 19-year-old obviously has a brilliant potential in career mode and was one of the Premier League breakout stars this season. So Declan Rice, welcome. And I know a lot of you Irish guys hate him, but just give him a chance in this rebuild, all right? All right, so I lied about one more signing. We're able to squeeze the transfer budget to its last remaining few dollars and pick up Fulham's golden boy, Ryan Sessegnon. He helped them get promotion last season to the Premier League and has been linked with so many big clubs around England in the transfer window. Didn't really have the best season in the Premier League, but we've gone ahead and picked him up for £10.8 million. I know I say this pretty much every second transfer, but yet another bright young English talent, only 18 years of age, 75 overall, has got bags of potential on him. Hopefully he can fulfill it under David Beckham. So I think this will be our last piece of transfer business. The Ivorian Serge Aurier is off to AC Milan. He is joining the Milan club at the San Siro for £20 million. The now 25-year-old right back, 80 overall, he's been on the move throughout his whole career. So our summer transfer window business comes to a close here with Spurs. David ended up spending $356 million and ended up selling $302.5 million worth of players. An absolutely insane window there. As it comes to a close now, this is how the side will be lining up for the first half of the season. I think it's pretty solid so far. We're going to check up on them at the halfway stage, see how Beckham is doing halfway through his debut season. And looking at this Premier League table halfway through the season, it's got a sting. We are nowhere near where we want to be. We're currently sitting outside the top six in seventh position. Not where I first imagined this Spurs side would be, but think about it. Chelsea and Arsenal are below us, as well as Everton. And it's Wolves and West Ham in the top four. This is such a weird Premier League table. To be fair, we're only 3 points outside of the top four, so all can be redeemed in the second half of the season. Hopefully Beckham can pull this around. We've got Manchester United in round three of the FA Cup, so I'm not sure if we're going to get out of that one, but it'll be a tight one. We're in the semi-finals of the Carabao Cup, and it looks like if we get past Watford, it's likely going to be Manchester City in the finals. And our poor Premier League form has been replicated here in the Champions League group stage. To be fair, it was a very, very tough group with Barcelona and Inter, but we finish in third. Therefore, going to the Europa League, we only got 5 points out of that one, but we've got RB Leipzig in the round of 32 in the Europa League. In all due respect to the Europa League, I really do not care how we go in this competition. All right, so the January transfer window is up and running here. We sell yet another wing back here. Ben Davies, the Welshman, 25 years of age, is off to Fenerbahce. He's making the move to the Turkish League for £17.3 million. He's from the UK, but he's not English, so he's out of the club. And the sales just keep on coming this January. The next one on the chopping block is Vincent Janssen, the Dutch striker, now 24 years of age. He's headed off to fellow Premier League side in Burnley for £7.7 million. Vincent Janssen is out the door to Turf Moor. All right, then, this one's a big one. Barcelona have come in for the big Belgian centre-back, Toby Alderweireld, former Southampton man, now 29 years of age. He is making the move to La Liga for £38.2 million. Big boy Toby is headed out the club. And we were able to make a little utility signing here in January. It's going to be Ainsley Maitland-Niles coming from Arsenal, which a transfer between two clubs that you don't really see too often or don't even see at all. Arsenal and Spurs, obviously very, very fierce rivals, but Maitland-Niles, the very versatile defender and midfielder, is going to make the switch to the England Revolution. Got a lot of potential on career mode as well, so I'm keen to see how he does in the side. So that's going to conclude the January business for Spurs. A few sales there. Deadline day is now over. We're going to save our money for season two because there's a few players who were just made the transfer or we can't pick up right now that I do definitely want to pick up in the near future. But hopefully we can see a big improvement in the side as we need to get our act together in the second half of the season. All right, I'd say that's quite a turnaround from Spurs and the English Revolution in season one. They've crept up from seventh and snuck into fourth position by 3 points, qualifying for next season's Champions League, which is good because we didn't really do that well in the Champions League this year. Man City, Man United in the top two. Liverpool finish in third. Meanwhile, we scroll to the bottom. Arsenal were in 10th, but Southampton, Huddersfield and Watford all getting relegated down to the Championship. So I said it was going to be a tough draw in round three, and we somehow have made it all the way to the final of the FA Cup up against Manchester City. This is going to be a big one, obviously Beckham's first cup final. So we're going to see how he does in simulated, but it's up against English champions Manchester City. It's going to be a big one. And of course, we're coming up against City, who have already won the Carabao Cup 4-1 to Watford. So obviously it's going to be a very tough time for us. And I still can't believe we lost to Watford in the semi-final 3-2 on aggregate, but not one cup final. Beckham has somehow got himself into two cup finals, this time a European final. We went to the Europa League this season and we've somehow crawled our way into the final after a terrible first half. The English Revolution have pulled it around here in the second half of the season. And just when I thought all hope was lost, we somehow pull this one out the bag. So it's the FA Cup final first and Rashford has gone down injured. So Sterling's going to have to be a makeshift striker and Sessegnon is filling that left wing position of Sterling. Wembley awaits us. It's going to be a very, very tough match, but let's hope the boys can pull a result out the bag here. All right, Man City obviously on a big run of form here. Can we go ahead and upset them here in the capital? Obviously, they've traveled down from Manchester. Can we do it in London? Oxlade-Chamberlain with a yellow card. Kompany gets a goal. We're going to skip it. And we've somehow won 3-2 in extra time. I thought that was going to definitely be a loss in the final. But Harry Kane coming in trumps with a brace, as well as Dele Alli, the two Tottenham boys in real life, turn up here in the cup final, upsetting Manchester City, Mahrez and Kompany with their goals, Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain with a red card. How we've managed to do that, I will never know. What a five-goal thriller. And it also went the distance to 120 minutes, so I am so proud of the boys right now. And there it is. Your eyes do not deceive you. Spurs have actually won a trophy. Spurs have won the FA Cup. I know. Just like transfers, something that doesn't happen very often with Spurs. So one cup final down, one to go, and we've had to really rearrange the squad here. Loftus-Cheek comes in. Hudson-Odoi comes in. Maitland-Niles comes in. It's a double barrel surname galore in the middle of the park. It's a really rotated squad, and if we didn't finish in the top four, I'd say this is a do or die game. We needed to win this in order to qualify for the Champions League, but considering Beckham pulled it around in the league in the second half, this isn't as big of a game as we once thought it would be. However, we go into this one against AC Milan, Italian giants. Çalhanoğlu gets the lead for Milan. We're going to skip it. Caldara gets the second. And our heavily rotated side go down 2-0 in the Europa League final. AC Milan qualify for the Champions League, but it doesn't really matter in the end as we finished in fourth. I'm still proud of the boys though. And our big performers this season, as expected, were Dele Alli and Harry Kane. Harry Kane with 33 goals, our top goal scorer. Dele Alli getting double figures in both goals and assists. Jack Grealish getting in off the bench with 5 goals and 7 assists. Harry Winks doing a bit in there. Marcus Rashford obviously picked up a big injury, but he's still got double figures in goals. Ryan Sessegnon got involved, as well as Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain in the middle of the park. Jadon Sancho doing well. Kieran Trippier and Danny Rose, our wingbacks, also doing quite well. Raheem Sterling, you'd sort of expect a bit more from him as we paid over 70 million for him, but he's always got season number two to improve. John Stones with 17 clean sheets. It's what you want to see from the big centre back. But otherwise, that is going to be the end of season number one. We're going to season two very, very hopeful. As we've already won a domestic cup competition, we just need to go out and win the Premier League and the Champions League. It's a bit of a big ask from David Beckham, but we're going to see what he pulls off in his second stint at Tottenham. So summer's come, it's a new season, a new dawn, a new day. This is the side going into our second season, and Beckham has £185.45 million to spend this transfer window in order to beef up the squad, provide some depth and quality to the side, and continue on ticking off our goals this season. So it's first signing of the season, it's a back backup striker, Mr. Tammy Abraham, the man who fired Aston Villa into the Premier League this season, gained them promotion and now making the switch to North London. The ex-Chelsea loanee is going to be a backup for Harry Kane and Marcus Rashford up top. He's got a brilliant potential on career mode as well, so he fits perfectly. So in order to compete in multiple competitions throughout a season, you've got to have squad depth, and that is the approach we're taking towards season two. Callum Wilson, Bournemouth striker, who's recently been called up to the international stage, is going to make the move to Spurs. We've spent a total of £20 million on him, and yet again, he'll be a backup for Harry Kane and Marcus Rashford in the side. So a position in which England have an abundance of talent right now is the right back spot, and one player frontlining that position at the moment, Aaron Wan-Bissaka, is playing in the UEFA under 21 Euros at the moment. Coming from Crystal Palace for £20 million, a 21-year-old is going to join the English Revolution. David Beckham has picked the youngster up here, and he's joining a fellow London club. He might be on the move this summer in real life towards Manchester United, but that is a different story. Welcome to Spurs, Wan-Bissaka. So for the second time in this rebuild, Arsenal have let one of their players go to their bitter rivals in Tottenham. Rob Holding's going to make the switch for £12.2 million. Unai Emery is just freely giving us his players at the moment, and I'm sure Arsenal fans, yet again, aren't happy about that move. He's going to be a very, very decent backup centre-back. So after a rapid hot streak of signings starting off the summer transfer window, the American Carter Vickers comes back from loan, and the 21-year-old centre-back is going to be sold straight away to Aston Villa for £3.6 million. He's showing great potential, but yet again, he's not an Englishman, so he's out the door. And the two non-Englishman's contracts we are going to terminate here is going to be Anthony Georgiou. The Cypriot is going to have his contract torn up, as well as Georgia's Kevin Nkodu. They were both out on loan last season, and I just know it's going to be a struggle trying to sell them. So this way, we can achieve the objective of selling all the non-English players faster by terminating their contracts, and it just makes it way easier for us to complete the challenge. We still have a few more sales to get to, though, before the squad becomes all English. So a player that had a brilliant season in the Premier League this year was James Maddison for Leicester City. We've gone ahead and picked him up for £26 million. I thought it would have been a great signing for Spurs to make in real life. He would fit the mold perfectly. And if Christian Eriksen leaves in real life, would be a perfect fit for them. 22 years of age, center attacker, midfielder, 80 overall. He's got a brilliant potential as well. Yet another English midfielder with a brilliant potential. Welcome to Spurs, James Maddison. So a position we were really lacking in last season was the center half department, the defensive positionings. So we've gone ahead and picked up yet another bright prospect for England in the center back position, Joe Gomez from Liverpool. He moved to Watford in the first season, so we had to pick him up from there. £20 million is a bit of a decent deal for him, and he is going to be a brilliant backup center back option. So it's three major player departures here. The last three non-English remaining players at Spurs were Lucas Moura, Hugo Lloris, and Davinson Sanchez. The Colombian's off to Man United for £37.7 million. Hugo Lloris is off to Merseyside. He is joining Everton for £40 million. And Lucas Moura joining fellow London club in Chelsea for £50.3 million. Spurs' Champions League semi-final hat-trick hero is departing the club, as well as club captain Hugo Lloris. So it's yet another objective ticked off by David Beckham, selling all the non-English players at the club and ensuring that Tottenham is all English for this English takeover and revolution in North London. And just like the Belgian rebuild, we've got Raheem Sterling and we've got his brother Keziah Sterling in there as well. So after that healthy injection of money into our transfer budget, we've gone after the man who was on loan at Derby County this season, nearly got them promoted to the Premier League, Mason Mount, Frank Lampard's favourite little ones kid to use in the Championship, 20 years old, making the big money move to the Premier League. Yet again, another bright English prospect on career mode. They've got an abundance of them. You guys already know this, but Mason Mount, welcome to Tottenham. So ex-Manchester United Youth Academy prospect Jesse Lingard, J-Lings, is finally joining us here at Spurs. Taking a while for us to get him because he moved to RB Leipzig throughout this career mode, but we've gone ahead and picked him up for £33.6 million. Yet another great utility attacker to have in our English takeover. So it's finally an upgrade to the side in that left-back position. Yet another ex-Manchester United boy back-to-back. This time, it is Luke Shaw. £33.5 million we had to spend on him. Now 83 overall, 24 years of age. And if he doesn't get injured, I hope he is a mainstay in this side and is starting week in, week out. So considering we won the FA Cup last season, it is going to be a Community Shield final up against our FA Cup finalists. The team we beat last season, Manchester City. Doesn't really matter if we win this or not. Just another piece of silverware for us to get our hands on, and Manchester City get the 2-0 victory there. De Bruyne and Sané making no mistakes there. Unfortunately for the English boys, we weren't able to pick up the Community Shield. So that is going to be it for our summer transfer window. David Beckham is ready to get into his second season in charge. 195 million spent, 131 out the door. A big clear out here at Spurs. The English takeover is in full swing. It's in full effect. And let's see how the boys grow, develop, and perform this season in our charge towards a Premier League title and a Champions League title. I've got to go quickly because this Argentina-Paraguay game is absolutely kicking off. I'll see you at the halfway stage. So we've hit the ground running with our title challenge this season, sitting in second position, only 1 point behind Chelsea, who are league leaders for the time being. Leeds United somehow being in the top three. How that has happened, I will never know, but Manchester United sitting in fourth, Brighton in fifth, Arsenal and Liverpool currently outside the top four, Manchester City in 17th, but it's Middlesbrough, Burnley and Cardiff all in the relegation zone. This Premier League table in this entire rebuild has just been absolutely crazy. We're still in round three of the FA Cup. We pulled Brentford, so hopefully we can get through and progress through the later rounds. We're in the Carabao Cup semi-finals up against Newcastle United. Hopefully we can have another cup final to look forward to this season. And in the Champions League, our group was Dynamo Kiev, Napoli and Rosenborg. We absolutely destroyed it there. Napoli with a shock exit to the Europa League, but we finish on top with 14 points, undefeated in the group stage, and we pull Atletico Madrid in the round of 16. So a pretty tough opponent to meet in the knockout rounds of the UCL. So Beckham's going out and picking up some mid-season reinforcements here. A defensive midfielder, defensive central midfielder, kind of the anchor in the midfield. Lewis Cook is arriving from Bournemouth for £20 million. The 22-year-old will be a backup in midfield, but yet again, a quality English talent to have in the side, and I'm sure we'll get a bit of game time this season. So Morgan Gibbs-White, a young promising talent from Wolverhampton Wanderers, is going to come and join us here. Yet another central midfielder for only £6 million. The 19-year-old is an absolute steal from the Molineux Stadium. It's always good to have a few more players in our English takeover. So we decided to go ahead and pick up Mason Greenwood, Manchester United's young gun at the moment, under 21 Premier League top goal scorer for them. We snatched him away for £2.2 million and our 18-year-old got a great potential in FIFA 19 career mode. I know he probably won't grow to it. Welcome to the English revolution, Mason Greenwood. So it's a bit of a quiet transfer window for Beckham and Tottenham Hotspur, but we continue on in the second half of the season, going for glory, aiming big, dreaming big. Let's hope the North London club can do it in this English takeover. This is how the side is looking. So much quality across the pitch. Still players that can grow towards their potential, such as Sancho and Alexander Arnold. We've got the likes of Madison and Loftus-Cheek, Winks on the bench as well. And then we go into the reserves. There's even more depth. Some Tottenham youth talent as well. And some of the brightest young English talents that this game has to offer and football has to offer. We just got depth. This squad is stacked at the moment. Now all about getting the results, seeing those overalls go up and stats go up throughout the season. Let's see if the English lads can deliver. So we find ourselves in the Champions League semi-finals up against Real Madrid. The side is heavily rotated because a lot of players were down on stamina, but if we can snatch an away goal here, I'll be very happy. Let's see what we can pull off here in Spain. Real Madrid still have some quality players on their side. We're going to sim it, and we somehow went 1-0 up with Ryan Sessegnon getting a crucial away goal. Isco pulls it back to 1-1 in the 80th. That is a very solid result to take back with us to London. So it's a full-strength lineup going into the second leg of the semi-final. Ali's back, Sterling's back, Luke Shaw, Alexander-Arnold are back in the defense as well. So we welcome Real Madrid to our stadium. Hopefully we can pull off a very decent result and get into the final. So we're going to start it off here. Kane gets us underway with a goal. That puts us 2-1 up on aggregate. Beautiful stuff from the captain. What can the rest of the team do? We're into this first half. We wait it out or do the skip tactic. I'm not sure, but we've entered the second half now. Real Madrid do a few subs. We're going to skip it, and it remains 1-0. Harry Kane coming in clutch with a goal that sends us to the Champions League final in season number 2. That's got to be the quickest we've ever gotten to a Champions League final. Now, we're just got to see if we win the Premier League as well. That will top off this season and this rebuild challenge beautifully. And it looks like second season's a charm as David Beckham has gone on with this English takeover and edged out Chelsea to the Premier League title by 1 point. It took 83 points for Spurs to win the league, but they have finally done it. Chelsea runners up by a point. Man United and Arsenal finish off the top four. Arsenal in their famous fourth position. Liverpool sitting in fifth. Manchester City all the way down in 12th, but it's Burnley, Cardiff City and Middlesbrough all getting relegated. We find ourselves in a final of the FA Cup yet again. So along with the Champions League final, it's another final to look forward to. We ended up up winning the Carabao Cup, which I actually had no idea about. 1-0 to Bournemouth in the final, a pretty easy route, beating Newcastle in the semis and edging it out 1-0 like we always seem to be doing, just grinding out these results. And of course, we have a Champions League final to look forward to. Our opponents are going to be AC Milan. The Italian Giants beat PSG in the semi-final. Now we are meeting them in the big dance, the big ticket item for David Beckham and the English Revolution. He could set a record here. The first time a rebuild challenge has been done in 2 seasons. That is absolutely crazy. Here you have it, Harry Kane with the Premier League trophy. Will we ever see that happen in real life? I have no idea, but we've made it happen in this rebuild challenge. So as it is a cup final at Wembley right before our Champions League final, we might as well go ahead and simulate it. I mean, it can act as a little warm-up before the Champions League final. I'm praying for no injuries because this is our strongest starting 11. If I get injuries, it's going to bite me in the arse right here. But Alexander-Arnold gets a yellow card. We're going to skip it and edge United out for a 2-1 victory. What a performance from the lads. Of course, the captain, Harry Kane, gets the brace to lift up that FA Cup trophy. So right before we get into the Champions League final, we're going to take a look at our star performers this season. We're going to sort by appearances. And yet again, it's Dele Alli killing it. 2 seasons in a row, 21 goals, 13 assists, double figures in both. 18 goals for Marcus Rashford, an assist somehow for Jordan Pickford. Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain actually delivering in the middle of the park with 14 assists. Harry Kane, 43 goals. Mate, calm down. The captain has delivered above and beyond expectations there. 43 goals. That's like a Messi Ronaldo type season. Sterling with 10 goals, 9 assists. We go down. Continue on. Jadon Sancho with 10 assists there. Lingard getting involved. Harry Wing. Alexander-Arnold doing well, of course. And then we go down. Ryan Sessegnon. And these are the kind of players that didn't really get too much game time this year. Just showing how much quality we actually have in this side. So those were the players that got us all the way to this Champions League final. Now, all that is left to do is actually to go ahead and win this game. Beckham, in his first 2 seasons, has won a lot of silverware. He signed up a lot of young talent. This has been a great rebuild challenge with the English lads. I mean, everyone knows they've got so much youth development and so many young talents coming up through the ranks. So it's exciting times to be an English football fan. We can go out and win this thing. So let's go ahead and do it. So Manchester is calling. Old Trafford is the venue for the Champions League final. A very fitting venue in terms of this video, but we're getting things kicked off here with Raheem Sterling and Harry Kane. Gives it off to Dele Alli. There's a lot of space here for Raheem Sterling already, and he started it off between the legs of Gigi Donnarumma. Slots it through to the back of the net. What was the Milan defense doing there? And 3 minutes in, we've gotten this rebuild final off and running. Dele Alli picked out the pass beautifully. The Milan defense just bundled up together and let Raheem Sterling run free. And Donnarumma couldn't keep that one out. Low and hard from the English winger. We are 1-0 up against AC Milan. Paquetá again, the Brazilian. We know how dangerous he can be. Obviously a beast in career mode. Suso gives it back to Klosterman. Can we close him down? We do. Harry Winks can start up a counter-attack here. Raheem Sterling back in the middle to Dele Alli. He's giving it away to the French midfielder, Ayor. Christophe Piontek Back to Suso, Christoph Piontek. He's put a ball in. Suso has found the equaliser. How have we let that pass? The Spanish winger played a little 1-2 with Christoph Piontek, and they've gotten the equaliser 20 minutes into the game. This is going to be a wild night here at Old Trafford. Great team play from Milan. What was our back four doing? We weren't tracking the runs. We didn't close them down. And we've conceded the equaliser there. Back to Harry Winks. Can he strike one from distance? He does, but Donnarumma saw it all the way. Oh no, what a ball in for Suso. Can Luke Shaw catch up to him? He closed him down. Suso wins it back. It's Lucas Paqueta. What a save from Jordan Pickford, preventing AC Milan from taking the lead. At his near post, he was alert to that one. Big up Jordan Pickford. Tolisso off to Ayor. Lucas Paqueta with a bit of Brazilian skill. We managed to close him down. Can we get a counter going? Jadon Sancho and Marcus Rashford. I'm loving this little duo down this right-hand side. Alexander-Arnold finds the ball into the box. What can Jadon Sancho do? He cuts it back. The finesse shot takes a deflection, and it's in the back of the net. 38 minutes in. Jadon Sancho down the right-hand side beats the entire Milan defense. A brilliant goal from the Englishman, and we are up and running in the first half. 2-1 up. We take back our lead, and Trent Alexander-Arnold with an assist. It was a fake shot to fool the defense. Took a wicked deflection there from Caldara, and now we go 2-1 up right before halftime. Oh, not a third before halftime. Raheem Sterling with a beautiful little run. He'll sweat it across to Rashford. It's going to be parried out, and someone's taking a shot at it. Harry Kane had a go, but it's deflected over the bar. Surely not a third before halftime. Sancho will whip it in. It's fallen to Dele Alli. Beautifully blocked, but Sterling, Raheem Sterling, gets to the follow-up. He's gotten a brace in the final. And this has been an action-packed opening 45 minutes. What has transpired here, I will not know, but it was way too fast for me to even think what was going on. Dele Alli had a shot, and Raheem Sterling following it up, smashing it into the top left-hand corner. A brilliant finish from him. Unsavable for Donnarumma, and we go 3-1 up right before the break. And the AC Milan deal with it for now, but that is going to be the end of the first half. That's been one of the most action-packed first-half finals I have ever played. But yet again, we still have the second 45. The fat lady has not yet sung. We'll be looking to win the trophy in the second half. Can he pick out a pass? It's Dele Alli in the open. He's gonna flick it up. He's gonna take it on the volley, and it's just gone over the crossbar. Sancho wins the header somehow. It's fallen to the feet of Marcus Rashford. He's gonna work his way around the defense. Harry Kane, a beautiful turn from him. It's back to Raheem Sterling. He's going to cut inside. Can he find someone at the back post? It's Marcus Rashford. And right in front of the Stretford end, where he used to score all his goals for Manchester United, he gets the fourth here in the 52nd. It is looking to be an embarrassing and a long night for AC Milan, but a very successful night for Beckham and his boys. A big jump, a big leap for Marcus Rashford, and he finds himself a Champions League final goal. Lucas Paqueta, yet another danger man for AC Milan. Tolisso doesn't know what to do with it. Dele Alli will win it back. And Harry Kane, can he find a good ball through to Marcus Rashford? It looks like he's still on goal here. Can he get a brace in the final? Will it be five? It will be. Marcus Rashford, it's just way too easy for the English boys. Absolutely dominating AC Milan on and off the pitch. What a performance so far. We're only an hour through and we're already 5-1 up. This is absolutely incredible. A great performance. A five-star performance. If only they did this in real life against Liverpool, but that is a different story. A brilliant finish into the bottom right-hand corner. And Rashford, as well as Sterling, have a brace. Piontek finds Suso again. He has a strike, but it's straight at Pickford. Feels so dangerous going forward. We've got so much pace going for us. And I think that's why AC Milan haven't been able to handle us. Counter-attack gone, but it's 10 minutes to go, and it looks like we are running away with this game. AC Milan on an attack. Samu Castillejo just come on. Christoph Piontek, and what a save from Jordan Pickford. And AC Milan have just not taken their chances tonight. That is the whistle blown. We complete the rebuild challenge here with David Beckham at the helm of Tottenham Hotspurs. A brace from Sterling, a brace from Rashford, an individual brilliance goal from Jadon Sancho will put us 5-1 past AC Milan in the Champions League final. The boys are going to be rejoicing. David Beckham having a success in his managerial stint, guys. I hope you have enjoyed this rebuild challenge. If you have, make sure to slap a big fat like on the video. Make sure to subscribe down below so you never miss out on a video on the channel. Follow me on Twitter. The link is in the description. Turn on notifications. Comment down below what you have in mind for a rebuild challenge, and it might just turn into a video. I'm going to leave you with Captain Harry Kane lifting up the trophy for the English Revolution.